I told Sam to call the police right away, but you know how stubborn he was. He said he'd tell you the next day when you went fishing. He didn't think much about it. He said a lot of youngsters did target practice in the woods and that she was probably shooting at squirrels. We didn't sleep well that night. Got up earlier than usual, just before dawn. While we were having breakfast, we heard a car. We thought that was odd. But that wasn't the case.
Sam! Oh my God, Sam!
She made me cover him with a blanket. And then she dragged me away from him. She locked me up with the baby in the bunker and said she'd be back in a few hours. I called a phone down there. I tried to call the police, but I no longer knew what time it was. So I braced myself for her return. How am I going to live without him, Adam? What will I do?
Well, you could get ready for dinner. Otherwise, Jenny will be asleep when her grandma gets there.
Oh, I forgot about Eddie's apple pie. I hope I didn't burn it.
Jenny, sweetheart, tell your daddy to stop writing and come play with us. He's ignoring Grandpa.
Huh? If you keep that up, you'll finish writing that novel in record time.
Thank you. Maybe.
Does 10 years sound record-breaking to you?
What's on your mind?
This morning, I finally got a call from my acquaintance at the state adoption agency. It seems like the agency that Robert hired for Veronica's adoption hid relevant information about her biological family.
What?
They molested her. They broke her. I don't even want to think about it.
Bastards. Does that explain everything? Why she was a psychopath?
It's possible. Many victims of abuse become abusers themselves. Veronica's trauma ran so deep that not even Robert's love could save her. Perhaps if she had received help as a child, none of this would have happened.
I suppose we are all broken in one way or another. We don't all become Veronica, but we're not saints either.
I thought you didn't want to interfere with my job.
Hey, who's been interfering with mine for the past week? When are you leaving?
This afternoon.
When I'm done with all the paperwork, if you're not busy, I know there's someone waiting for you in L.A. But Cerro Lake is beautiful this time of year, and,
There is someone, but I've given him far too many opportunities. And none to Cerro Lake. We could go back to Mama Louise.
There are so many things I haven't tried yet.
Well played, kitty.
Please, don't touch her! She's just a baby! Don't touch her!
She's my damn daughter!
From the point where he touched you, the dog,
I found you a new daddy. Do you understand what I'm saying?
I love you too, sweetie. To the moon and back.
You're not crazy, honey. You're not a bad girl.
Will we still be friends when I'm gone?
She's your daughter, Ed.
Shut up.